The Thomas Crane Public Library's feature film series continues on Thursday, May 29th, with a documentary entitled Chasing Ice. It's a film concerning climate change here on Earth, and it's being sponsored in part by Quincy Climate Action Network. And joining us here today in the studio is Rebecca McWilliams, the chair of QCAN. Rebecca, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me, John. I just want to mention some of the other sponsors of this event. It's also sponsored by the Sustainable South Shore Group, Massachusetts Audubon, North and South Rivers Watershed Association, South Shore Natural Science Center, and finally the Stellwagen Bank National Marine Sanctuary, in addition to QCAN.
And we should mention that representatives from all those organizations will be at the film series, and they'll be taking a question and answer as well after the film is completed.
Correct. So the time is, once again, May 9th, 7 to 9 p.m. It's only an 80-minute long film, so we'll have quite a good discussion afterwards, and we hope that people can stick around for that.
Now, the film was a National Geographic film, mm-hmm. and they've called it the largest thing to happen to humans on Earth.
The biggest story in human history.
Yes. So certainly it's a big thing that National Geographic has taken upon. And it was started in the spring of 2005 in the Arctic by photographer James Blong. He himself was a skeptic about climate change until he went in and saw what was happening. Talk a little about that.
Sure. So it takes place over about 6 years. Basically, the photographer went to the Arctic to check out what was happening with ice. And he was amazed by what he was seeing with the receding and then disappearing ice. And it's sort of a question of, what do you need to see in order to believe that climate change is actually happening? And for him, this changed his life.
Now, it's one of those things where you can't just go back and see it happening. And he did a lot of time-lapse photography. And again, it was over years of this photography. And he could then see in years down the seconds, you can see, you know, the ice falling and it happening along those lines.
Correct.
And like I mentioned, it's won several awards at several different film festivals. And it's just going to be a screening talking about what's happening. And it's going to be talking about also afterwards how we can stop the climate change and how we can help it.
Well, at this point, unfortunately, there really is no way to stop climate change, but certainly we are trying to slow it down and to mitigate what's happening in all of our communities. So sort of to segue, one of the things that's been in the news a lot is what's happening with sea level rise and potential flooding issues. I know in Quincy that's been a huge issue. I've been talking to my neighbors about these new FEMA flood maps that have come out, and certainly there are things that everyone in Quincy can do to stop throwing energy out the window, throwing dollars out the window, stop heating your house and basically heating the environment. So what we've been saying as Quincy Climate Action Network is what you should do as a resident of Quincy is get your home a checkup, right? You get your car a checkup every 3,000 miles or so. You get yourself a physical once a year. When's the last time you actually had a professional look at your house and determine where you can be more efficient with the energy and the use of fossil fuels or renewable energy potentially in your home? So really that's what we're trying to push for our neighbors, our businesses, and our government in the city. And just to segue from that, one of the things that Quincy Climate Action Network has been very involved in is the Mayor's Climate Change Committee. Another big item that's been in Quincy news lately is the huge solar panel power purchase agreement that the city just executed with a private solar vendor. This is really great news because the city pays nothing, and on 27 city buildings, including many schools, we are now going to have solar panels that will be able to bring in electricity at a reduced rate to each of those city buildings. So that's a fantastic program, and we'd love to encourage people to check that out as construction starts this spring.
Now, people can find out more information on Quincy, the Quincy Climate Action Network's website, which is quincycan.org. Mm-hmm. Energy efficiency, energy conservation, renewable energy, and probably importantly, and this might get people to listen a little bit more, ideas to saving energy, saving money by saving energy as well.
Correct. It's all about the bottom line. And the interesting thing is, you're actually paying right now for these energy upgrades. It's up to you to choose to take advantage of this. So right now on your energy bill, you'll see that MassSave is taking a small percentage of every monthly bill that you pay. And if you apply for it, you can actually get that money back for your own home. So it's a win-win. The money's out there and it's something that you can take advantage of.
Now you talked about home energy audits. If people are interested, can they contact Quincy Climate Action Network to get more information
about
that?
We have a link on our website. We'd love for people to go on our website, click on the link, and sign up for a home energy audit. But the word audit is a little bit bit strong. I mean, we're around tax time this spring. No one wants to talk about audits. So we're calling it a home energy checkup.
Okay.
Get a checkup. But yes, it's the same thing. And we would certainly love to help people get an audit or a checkup. Go to our website, qcan.org.
Now, QCAN has been around since October of 2012, formally, talking about climate change, renewable energy, and helping residents. You're always looking for more people to come and join you, though, correct?
Absolutely. We would love to have more people join us. We're all volunteer. It's free to come to any meeting you'd like to. At some point, we would love for you to join us. Fees are very, very low. It's $25 to become a member annually. And if you aren't able to actually formally join us, we would still be interested in a donation. We certainly have some great programs to educate residents going on, including this Chasing Ice film series that we're co-sponsoring.
So possibly a good idea would become see the documentary Chasing Ice on May 29th. Also get some more information about Quincy Climate Action Network and just learn more about climate change and what people can do to kind of slow it down a little bit, if you will.
Absolutely.
All right, sounds good. So once again, on Thursday, May 29th, Chasing Ice, a documentary about climate change here on Earth. It'll be at the Thomas Crane Public Library. For more information, thomascranelibrary.org.